Hey everyone, just a quick video here, hopefully it's quick. I'm going to attempt to make some homemade butter with 16 ounces of heavy whipping cream. This is just the Great Value brand, and an old hand mixer. So I'm not even sure how long it's going to take me with a hand mixer, but if I happen to have to speed up the video because it's taking so long, I'm going to tell you guys exactly how long it took me. So let me get started here. And one other thing, I've watched other videos and there's a debate. If you want salted butter, do you add the salt before or after? So I've come to the conclusion after watching many videos that I'm gonna add the salt after. Because it seems like if I just add the salt to the heavy whipping cream, at the end when you're getting rid of the buttermilk, the salt is all in the buttermilk and not much left in the butter. So that's what I'm gonna do. Anyway, let's get started. Okay, so exactly 5 minutes right now. My arm's getting tired, but I'm gonna keep going. I feel like I'm coming up on some whipped cream in about 3 minutes. Let's see. Okay, so it looks like we have some whipped cream. And my arm is a little tired. It's 7 minutes, so I'm gonna keep going. Thank you. guys. Thank you so much. Wow. See? ask him for the buttermilk. Okay, so I'm going to drain the buttermilk, and I'm going to make sure everything is done, and I'm going to rinse it, and I will be right back. This is what it looks like. Okay, I drained the buttermilk. If you want to keep it, you can. So I have it in a clump right here. So I'm going to continue to rinse it out. You're supposed to rinse the butter until the water runs clear. So it doesn't go rancid, and that way you can keep the butter in your fridge for about 2 or 3 weeks. I'm going to add salt right now. I'm going to continue to rinse the butter, and I'll be right back. Okay, so here's how my butter turned out. After it's rinsed, you can take like a cheesecloth, or if you have some really good thick paper towels, make sure you get all the moisture out, and that way you can form it into like a stick or, you know, whatever you want to put it in. So that's what it turned out like. And I was also going to make some homemade bread today, but I bought some instead. So I'm going to taste this in just a minute. I did add the salt also. And this is what it looks like. You guys saw me make butter in real time. I don't know if it looks yellow to you guys, because I'm looking on the camera, it looks white. In person, it looks more like a yellow. But it turned out great, I think. You guys, it is so good, so creamy. Just the right amount of salt. It's not salty, but it tastes like, you know, salted butter like you buy in the store. Real butter. It's just really, really good. Really simple to make. And that's what it looks like. Spreads really easy. It tastes just like butter. It's really, really good. I can't describe it. But yeah, since this is my first time, I'm just like really shocked how good it tastes and how easy it was. But there it is. Thanks for watching. Bye.